So really what you're asking me is, what is the value of creativity and how do we enhance it? Well, in really, we had what was called, I mean, I've discussed this with some people about how we're shifting from different, different ages. So you had the industrial age, where our existing educational system fit very well. You needed people to work on assembly lines, you needed them to follow directions, and you didn't need to be very creative. In fact, creativity was a drawback. You wanted the round peg and the round hole and the square peg and the square hole, and you wanted them on that line, and you didn't want them complaining much. You wanted them to do exactly what you want them to do and nothing else. We started to shift from the industrial society, as Peter Drucker, the management crew, said in the 1980s, to a knowledge society. Well, then knowledge became more important. The knowledge workers were the people that succeeded. The Jobs, the Wozniaks, the Dells, the Allens, the Ted Turners, the guys at Facebook, the guys at Twitter, Ted Turner, the guys could amass knowledge and figure out how to use it to help people get more value in their lives. Were the people that added the most value, they got the most financial return. So we became in a knowledge society. Well, now information is doubling every 18 months. That's what some of the experts say. It's really kind of a nebulous point that a lot of people pick out, but it seems to be the one that people are using at the moment. Now, when knowledge is doubling every 18 months, it's not only knowledge that's important, because think of all the knowledge there is on the internet. You can't possibly have all that. In my field, at one time, I think it was in the 1990s, there were 20,000 research papers on long-term memory formation. And there was a major neuroscientific conference, there was a proposal put forth to suspend the research so we could all catch up. So there's no way we can catch up, right? So what happens is we've gone into a new phase, which really I see as the creative society. How to identify what knowledge is important and then put that knowledge together in the way that can transform really our world or what you're working on. That's kind of what the Twitter guys and the Facebook guys did. And a lot of the technology companies are doing that. But the key is you've got to be quick, you've got to be fast. So you've got to figure out how to amass knowledge quickly. And then what you got to do is figure out how to put it together quickly in new ways. Now, these are different brain structures than what our educational system is teaching. What our educational system is doing for 18 years of your life, what they're doing is knowledge, the kind of knowledge that you just store, like when Columbus got to the, got to the New World. That's what's stored in what's called your rear associative areas in the back of your head. So you can start downloading lots of data. Matter of fact, there's so much data downloaded in our lives right now that our brains are 20% heavier, one expert says, than our grandparents. Because they had ABC, NBC, CBS. We've got 500 channels, of which we probably can name off 30 or 40 of them. That equals mass in the head because that's basically neurological material. So what happens is, for creativity, we're not using really the rear associative areas like we used to. It's still important. What we're using are these prefrontal areas, the ventromental prefrontal cortex, the orbital medial prefrontal cortex, the lateral prefrontal cortex. We're using these prefrontal areas that make us human. They're the part of the brain that allows us to see how the world is interconnected, how the pieces come together, how they fit together. They also let us see our connectedness to our fellow man and how we can add value to him. It's really what spirituality and religion access those areas. Now, I'm being very metaphoric and very general, but those are the areas that make us different than the animals. That's why we have religions and spirituality, and our dogs may have it and cats may have it at some level, but not at the conscious level we do. We're aware of this. So these brain areas are vitally important to be activated in order for us to develop the creative process that's going to allow us to adapt most effectively in a world where information's changing every 18 months. And what we do is when we lock a child in a small box, 25 by 36 feet, what happens to that brain is, and when we only talk to them and tell them to memorize, what we're doing is we're activating the rear associative areas, which are, having some knowledge is good. But what happens is we're totally cutting out the prefrontal areas that are vital for our ability to create. And imagine when you lock somebody in a box for 18 years and you don't ask them what's important to them and don't let them create from what's meaningful to them, those areas do not get the glucose, the oxygen and glucose that come from your carotid and vertebral arteries. That power is redirected to another area in your brain that grows. So the part of your brain that grows is passing tests or amassing information to pass a test, which I forget on purpose because I don't really need it. So what we really want to do is focus on those prefrontal areas so that children can fire those over and over again and become quick adapters in the world because their creativity is high.